I recently stumbled across a park in Russia called Sochi Park. It's located near Georgia in southern Russia, and it looks to be one of the coolest amusement parks I've ever seen, so I just had to make a video on it. This is my full analysis on one of the coolest amusement parks, Sochi Park. Just a quick disclaimer, I haven't been to Sochi Park before. This is not a review, this is just an analysis of the park based on information and videos online. With all of that said, let's jump into the analysis. This park is quite a large place. Directly next to Sochi Park is a big Olympic Park. Inside the Olympic Park is a stadium, auto museum, skate park, and much more. Sochi Park is located right next to this wonderful place, so that is already a big plus. Inside the theme park is a massive hotel, which is basically a castle. The park runs a medieval theme, which is observable in the names of rides and, of course, the hotel. Right next to this medieval-style hotel is a bunch of small stands where you can buy everything you need for the day ahead in the amusement park. Already, this place looks themed and incredible, and I haven't even talked about what's inside the gates. Before we wander into the park, let's talk about the history of Sochi Park. Sochi Olympic Park was constructed for the 2014 Winter Olympics, and has many different stadiums and activities, including many rides and attractions inside the theme park. The theme park is currently home to four different coasters and many different attractions. The entire park looks to be full of joy, with neons and vibrant colors everywhere. Every building and attraction pops out, and it looks to be a wonderful place. Even the hotel of the park lights up at night with color, which is way better than what American resorts do. Let's hop into the roller coasters. Sochi Olympic Park has a very small coaster collection, but two of these rides really stand out to me as being some of the best coasters in the entire country of Russia. Let's begin with the smaller of the four coasters. One of the park's coasters is a yellow wild mouse that goes by the name Bullflyer. While this is just a wild mouse, it's pretty new, opening in 2014 along with other coasters and rides in the park. It looks relatively good as it starts off with a small drop instead of turns like a typical wild mouse coasters. This wild mouse is similar to Apple Zapple or Coast Rider, so it looks better than the others. Another small coaster is one of only two in the world, called Drifter. I have never seen this coaster before, but it looks like a very unique experience. Drifter is made by IE Park and is similar to a suspended swinging coaster, except the cars are on top of the track. The layout is just a helix, but with every cycle it swings rapidly and it looks like a very intense and fun experience. Now let's get into the big coasters. The first big coaster is called Quantum Leap. Quantum Leap is a purple giant inverted boomerang, which is already a great coaster model. Quantum Leap is one of the better giant inverted boomerangs as it still has the typical Vekoma seating. This means that it'll still provide the intense and smooth experience similar to Aftershock at Silverwood. Finally, there is Serpent Dragon, the best coaster in the park. Serpent Dragon is a Blue Fire clone, which is a Mock Rides launch coaster. Unfortunately, this one is set on flat terrain, so there aren't any trees or rockwork to be seen, but the entrance may be the best entrance I've seen on a coaster. The entrance is made up of three massive dragon heads sticking out of a castle. This is one of the most in-depth coaster entrances ever, and I absolutely love it. Besides the coasters, what else is there to do in Sochi Park? Like I mentioned before, this place has beautiful surroundings. Just across the street is the Black Sea, and of course, there is a massive Olympic Park, which is the reason this park exists in the first place. At night, there is a show using images through water fountains. This show looks absolutely incredible, and it looks like it could rival some shows at Disney and Universal parks. The fountains even go along with music, and one image is a dragon flying through the air. Also in the evening, the midways of the park light up the night, and all of those vibrant colors before are now illuminated. The hotel, like I mentioned before, looks better than ever at night as well. In the park, there are some other attractions. The park doesn't have too many other attractions, but the rides it does have are pretty good. Of course, it has the fairy tale theme throughout the kids' rides, with the teacups and the pirate ship to ride. There are some other thrill rides like Firebird, which is a pretty large drop tower standing near the back of the park. There is also a water attraction where passengers can shoot the guests on the path with water shooters. Dodgems, of course, exist here, and so does Magic Flight, which is a crazy fairground-type ride where riders spin around while being thrown out of their seats. After all of the rides, the park has many different things to do in shops. There is a massive candy store located in the park, as well as a roller coaster restaurant, similar to Europa Park. The roller coaster restaurant is where your food rolls down a track right onto your table. Something to note is that this park also houses animals. On the website, the park says to have a dolphin and an owl show, which is always a nice touch for a theme park. Sochi Park is full of a bunch of different things to do. So what do I think of Sochi Park? I think that this park needs to be talked about more, as it is one of the coolest and most unique parks I've ever seen. The variety in attractions here is incredible. You have your thrill-seeking rides with the roller coasters and drop towers. You have the family rides and the kids rides. I really love how the park keeps the medieval theme alive, as every single building, show, and ride is crafted carefully to keep that vibe. There is so much to do here, from visiting the sights around the park, watching the shows, riding the rides, and so much more. This park is like the Europa Park of Russia. If I lived closer to the park instead of living on the other side of the world, I would be going here all the time just for the theming alone. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe, as it helps out the channel a lot. Make sure to comment below your thoughts on Sochi Park, and have a great rest of your day.